नमस्कार। टुडे वील स्टडी दिस सनबर्न एंड सनस्क्रीन्स और सनस्क्रीन एजेंट्स। सो एज यू नो द विजिबल रेंज ऑफ लाइट इज 400 टू 760 नैनोमीटर व्हिच इंक्लूड्स योर लाइट रेज ऑफ डिफरेंट कलर्स विद ग्योर violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. So this V stands for violet, and below this, that is 200 to 400 nanometer, is your UV light or UV rays. And this UV rays again can be divided into UVA, UVB and UVC, and the highest one is the UVA, which is 320 to 400 nanometer. And this UVB is 290 to 320 nanometer, and below that, that is from 100 to 290 nanometer is UVC. So the ozone layer protects this UVC, and UVB causes sunburn characterized by erythema and tanning due to pigmentation, and UVA causes premature aging, wrinkles, and also cause skin cancer. If you compare UVA and UVB, there will be less erythema and pigmentation in UVA as compared to UVB. And there are certain patients who are sensitive to UVA, patients with drug-induced photosensitivity, or patients with cutaneous lupus erythematosus, and patients with polymorphous light eruptions, they are very much prone to UVA. So what happens when the UV light falls, UVB, falls, that is the UV light rays in the range of 290 to 320 nanometer, there will be dilatation of the blood vessels in skin. So once they are absorbed, they cause dilatation of the blood vessels, and that leads to local inflammatory reaction, which is resulting in erythema and pigmentation causing tanning. So that that we call as sunburn. And chronic exposure to sunburn causes aging and cancer. So sunscreens are the agents which act as barriers to sunlight and protect the skin from UV rays. And there can be two types of sunscreens or sunscreen agents: chemical sunscreens and physical sunscreens. The chemical sunscreens effective against UVA are called UVA sunscreens, and effective against UVB are called UVB sunscreens. And UVA sunscreens, that means all these agents, they absorb UV radiation. So those which absorb UVA radiation are benzophenones like avobenzone, oxybenzone, dioxybenzone, sulisobenzone, dibenzoyl methanes like parasol, usolex, and some other agents like methyl anthanilate, octocrylene, maxoryl SX, all these things. Similarly, those drugs which absorb UVB UV light in the range of 290 to 320 nanometer, they are PABA and esters like octyl dimethyl PABA, cinnamates like octyl methoxy, cinnamate salicylates like octyl salicylate, scopolitin, a glycoside from hymenodixon excelsum, and octocrylene also effective against UVB in addition to UVA. There can be agents physical sunscreens. These are inorganic compounds. They are opaque to all wavelength of light and can stop and scatter UV rays. So examples are heavy petroleum jelly, zinc oxide, talc, titanium oxide, and these are used in cosmetics and also used in barrier preparations against local dermatitis like nappy rash, and sometimes zinc oxide is added with dimethicone and water repellent. So regular use of sunscreens decrease the aging of skin, decrease the incidence of skin cancer, that is squamous cell carcinoma of skin, also decrease the reactivation of herpes or cold sore, and obviously it protects against sunburn. So the efficiency of all these sunscreen agents are measured by a factor called sun protection factor, or SPF, which is the ratio of minimal erythema dose with sunscreen agent divided by minimal erythema dose without sunscreen agent. So minimum effective dose is the dose of UV radiation required to produce a minimum erythema 24 hours after exposure in skin. So here in the unprotected skin, what is the dose, and after applying the sunscreen agent, what is the dose required to produce erythema. So that ratio above 10 is good, and the sunscreen efficiency is directly proportional to the sun protection factor, and higher the SPF value, the higher protection the sunscreen agent provides against the damaging effects of UV rays. And in fair skinned individuals, the SPF should be more than 15, because they are very much prone to damage by UV rays. Whereas in dark skinned individuals, the SPF can be 10 to 15, it can be 10 to 15, less than fair skinned individuals. So let us discuss one example. If a sunburn reaction occurs within a period of 20 minutes in an unprotected skin, and the person is using a sunscreen agent with SPF 15, then sunscreen agent protects the skin for how much time? So we can just multiply it with the time, that is this one, 20 minutes with 15, so it will be 300 minutes or 5 hours. So it will protect for 5 hours. So this is all about sunscreen agents. Thank you.